Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Mathematics. In this video we are going to discuss this interesting geometry problem. So there is a red square given to us whose side we know that is 17 cm. The diagonal of this square is defined here. And inside this square there is an orange square whose one of the vertex is common with the red square. So this is the orange square here. And its side is defined as 2r. Now what is r? R is defined as the radius of this circle. Now this is the circle which is touching the adjacent sides of this square. And we have also defined this point, and this is the point where this orange square is touching this circle also. And at that point we have defined this line inside this square. So using this information we have to find the radius of this circle. So this is our question. Now to solve this question, I will use two things here. First thing is the diagonal of the square, because we have been defined the diagonal of the square. And if you will notice, this diagonal of red square is the same one as the diagonal of the orange square. It means these are the same line. The lengths will be different, but we have defined the diagonal of two squares here. So that is the information I will use. Next information or property I will use, that of circle touching a line. So this is the circle touching three lines. I can see it is touching this line and this line. So that property also I will use. So by looking at this question, I know that geometrically I have to somehow find these values or use these properties to solve the question. So now first let me define the diagonal of the square. We know that if the side of the square is A, we can define the diagonal as A root 2. Because this angle is 90 degrees, so if you will apply Pythagoras theorem in this triangle, you will get this diagonal length that is equal to a root 2. So this is the value first which we will use. So let us come back to the question. So now I see two diagonals here. I have defined the points A, B and C. So I can define the diagonal AC here, that is of the red square. So now we know the side is 17, so we will define the diagonal as 17 root 2. Because if I define the side A, the diagonal is A root 2. So AC is 17 root 2. Now I can define the diagonal of this square also, because AB is its diagonal. So now the side is 2R. So AB I can define as 2R root 2. So whatever is the side multiplied by root 2 is the length of the diagonal of the square. Now, next part I will use the property, that is the circle touching a line. So now I will use this property. What is the property? If circle is touching a line, that line is defined as the tangent of the circle. So now what is the property of the tangent of the circle? The property of the tangent of the circle is that if we will plot the center of the circle and if we will draw a line joining the center of the circle to the point of contact of that line, that is the point where the line is touching the circle, and if you will join these two points, this line will always be perpendicular to the tangent, the line which the circle is touching. So in this way I can define two more lines here. So this is the center, this is the touching point. If I will define that as Q, and if I will join, this is 90 degree, and same is the case here. If I define this point B, if I will join this, this angle will also be 90 degree. And except the angle 90 degree, one more property is there, that this distance is nothing but the radius of the circle, because we know that from the center of the circle, any point on the circumference, the distance is always equal to the radius of the circle. So this length is nothing but r. So now by looking at this, I can see that there is one more square inside this red square. How is it possible? Because if you will see a circle inside a square, this angle is 90, this angle is 90, we have defined by using the property of tangent. This angle will be automatically 90 degree because this is a square. This is the angle at the vertex of the square. So the fourth angle inside this quadrilateral OQCP, this must be also 90 degree, because the quadrilateral all the sum angle must be 360 degree. So we can see that this square is also inside this square. So now we can define the diagonal of this square also. This is what we can do. So now there are total three squares. One is the red square, there was this orange square, now there is this yellow square, which I have defined using the property of circle touching a line. So we can define OC. OC will be equal to R root 2. That will be the diagonal length of this square. This is what we can define. Last length we have already defined, that is OB equal to R. So now I will use these lengths to find the value of the radius of the circle, which is our question. Now how will I find? Because I can see that this is the diagonal. That is the diagonal was for red square, and that was also the diagonal of the orange square, which I draw here. And this will also be the diagonal of this. This is yellow square. How is this possible? Because we can see that if we will draw these two points OC, this will be the diagonal, which we know that. And if you'll extend OA, this will also be the diagonal. Why? Because the angle here is 45 degree. The line making the angle 45 degree with this line will only be a single line. So this must be the diagonal of yellow square, red square, as well as the orange square. So this is a common diagonal, which we can see. It's an interesting problem. We have to derive to this conclusion. So now we can find the value of R. How we can find the value of R? Because we know the length of the diagonal, and we can define separate length AB, BO and OC. Using that, we will find the R value. So AC is the length of the diagonal of the red square, that is 17 root 2, which we can divide into three parts: AB plus BO plus OC. Now every other value I have already defined here. So I will put the value 17 root 2. AB is 2R root 2, BO is R root 2, OC is R. So from here I can take R common and I can add these values. So this will can define as 2R root 2 plus R root 2 is 3R root 2. Now I will take common. So this is R common 3 root 2 plus 1. So R can be defined as 17 root 2 divided by 3 root 2 plus 1. So this is the radius of this blue circle which we have defined. This is what we had to find. Now I can even further simplify this by rationalizing the denominator. Multiply this by 3 root 2 minus 1. So denominator 3 root 2 minus 1. So here the value is not plus, here it will be minus 1. So denominator it will be a square minus b square, because a plus b a minus b. So it will be defined as 3 root 2 square, that is 18, minus 1 square, that is 1. So this is 17, 17 will get cancelled out. So the remaining part which will be there will be root 2 multiplied by 3 root 2 minus 1. So this will multiply root 2 with root 2, that is 2 multiplied by 3, 6. Now the next value will be what? That is root 2 multiplied by 1, that is root 2. So the radius can also be written in a simpler way like this after rationalization, that is 6 minus root 2. So this was the method which I can think of. I have told you the thought process also, how did I approach the question. If you can think of any other method to solve this question, write in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I will see you in the next video.